Meanwhile, Hawaii officials on the island of Oahu have just held a press conference, and Courtney Friel was there. Courtney, you've been monitoring the situation there at the Pacific Tsunami Warning Center. What are they saying about the tsunami wave around the Pacific?
Hey, guys. Well, basically, they're saying that their readings are the same as before. There hasn't been much deviation from them. This means that they're still expecting around 3 a.m. local the possibility of waves up to 2 meters high. That's 6 feet, and that's above 6 feet above sea level. And it could take 20 to 30 minutes for all of the waves to sweep the Hawaiian Islands. It would hit the island of Kauai first. They're expecting the highest waves to be in Hilo or Haleiwa. That's on the Big Island of Hawaii. Now, they got these readings. They're pretty confident about Midway Island and Wake Island. Those are about 2.5 hours away from Hawaii here. So their readings they got on Midway Island was 1.5 meters above normal sea level. And on Wake Island, they got about a 0.5 meter reading, which they said was pretty significant for the small islands. And you're probably wondering, why then could we get 2 meters here? They said it's just because of the size of the islands. It could pick up as it moves along. It's very forceful, but it would just come in as a typical surf wave. But the buoys out here aren't going to help because those are weather buoys. Those aren't really picking up any tsunami waves. Mm-hmm. So their main message is, you know, they want to save lives. They want everyone to continue to evacuate if they haven't, you know, get to higher ground because even the smallest amount of water can knock someone over. Currently at this location, we're in Ewa Beach, which is the southwest part of the island of Oahu, and that is a beach level. So I asked if we were safe here, and they've never seen any tsunami activity on this part of the island. So that's good news because we're going to stay here through, you know, I guess we're just under 2 hours now from this happening, or maybe an hour.
Hey, Courtney. Can I ask you a question? You said that they're preparing there at the Tsunami Center for waves to hit Hawaii maybe 6 feet high. Now, you're on the southwest side of that particular island of Oahu. I would imagine that the people who would be most impacted would be on the north and the eastern side, or north and western side, that is to say, in the direction of Japan, right?
Correct. And I believe, I'm not sitting in front of the map of the Hawaiian Islands, I believe that's why they said Kauai is the first one that would get hit. So they're and Hilo and Haleiwa are the towns that they're more concerned about. And back in 1950, Hilo was hit really hard by a tsunami. And then again, this area that they're not as concerned about on the southwest part of the island. And they said, you know, even in Waikiki, I don't really sense that they're that concerned about that area specifically. But again, you know, they just want to, any amount of water can move a car or knock something over, like a person.
Right. Courtney, let's listen to the police warning because we were able to capture what was happening there in the middle of the night to alert the people in Hawaii.
Attention, attention. This is an emergency management message. A tsunami warning is in effect. Extremely dangerous tsunami waves are expected at 3 a.m. Everyone in the Waikiki area, stay off beaches, streets, and sidewalks. Move to higher ground. Visitors, return to your soil immediately and wait for further instructions.
You might as well sleep for a while.
Courtney, as we hear that, obviously people have heeded the warning. You know, most people in Hawaii know right now that they need to get to higher ground. Can you give me some perspective?
And those messages are playing on the TV. They're playing on the radio stations. You hear the sirens going out, the civil defense sirens. Those are very loud. There are police on the streets blocking off people from trying to get
Everybody's awake.
Yes, everybody's awake. I mean, everyone on this island is family anyways. Everyone knows everyone. So literally I was eating at a restaurant in Waikiki, and, you know, when we got the warning, headed back up to the mountain area where my in-laws were living, and by that time, they had already, you know, all been on the phones, and the phones are sketchy. The the service. They'd all gone to, you know, tried to go to the store, filled up the bathtub with water. I mean, people are taking this very seriously.
Right. Courtney, we know that there was a tsunami warning earlier after an earthquake hit Chile. Nothing happened. And a lot of people were saying, well, probably not, I hope they're not saying to themselves, it's probably going to be the same thing again. I hope they're taking it serious.
Yeah, and my husband grew up here on this island, and, you know, he is sensing that they always had tsunami warnings and never saw anything come of it. But he, you know, we were both on the street kind of freaking out. I mean, our hearts were pounding because everyone was, you know, thinking this is legit. And look at this earthquake and look at that devastation. And everyone who was near a TV and seeing what's going on, my gosh, I mean, they're hoping that nothing like that, you know, hits here.
So, Courtney, try and put it in perspective for me then, because you're talking to the officials there at the press conference. What does a 6-foot wave mean for Hawaii? Have they said that? As far as damage.
Right. As far as damage, we didn't elaborate on that. Basically, they were just coming out and giving the specifics on these two islands, on Midway Island and Wake Island, the level of the waves that they saw there, 1.5 meters and 0.5 meters, and that they're not deviating from their original prediction, that the estimate of the wave that could be seen here is anywhere from, you know, 0 centimeters to 2 meters, and it could be, you know, all different levels in different parts of the island, and that it might take 20 to 30 minutes for all the waves. They said it might not be the first wave. Right. You know, it could be a series of waves, and a powerful one could, you know, be 5 or 6 out or something like that. So they're going to come out again, right, you know, as they keep getting these readings, and I will be here and continue to update you guys.
Sounds good, Courtney.